Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Before you is a translation of a khutbah done in Dar al-Hadith in Dammaj, in Yemen, on the 20th day in the month of Dhul-Hijjah in the year 1426 al-Hijri by our noble Shaykh al-Nasih al-Amin Yahya ibn Ali al-Hajuri, hafidhahu Allah ta'ala, titled Tibul Hayati fil Mudawamati an al-Ta'at, which translates as Attaining the Goodness of This Life by Remaining Steadfast upon Righteous Deeds. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal that He benefits by Al-Islam and the Muslimin to proceed.
Alhamdulillah. نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله.
The Shaykh began by praising Allah. He said, "We praise Him, we seek His aid and His forgiveness, and I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped except for Allah alone, who has no partner, and I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a slave and His messenger."
يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون.
He then quoted the ayat, which translated is, "O you who believe, fear Allah as He should be feared, and die not except in a state of Islam."
يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا.
O mankind, be dutiful to your Lord, who created you from a single person, Adam, and from him he created his wife, and from them both he created many men and women, and fear Allah, through whom you demand your mutual rights, and do not cut the relations of the wombs. Surely Allah is ever an all-watcher over you.
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا يُصْلِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا أَمَّا بَعْدُ.
O you who believe, keep your duty to Allah and fear Him, and speak always the truth. He will direct you to do righteous good deeds, and will forgive you of your sins. And whomsoever obeys Allah and His Messenger, he has indeed achieved a great success. To proceed.
فَإِنَّ أَصْدَقَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ وَخَيْرَ الْهُدَى هُدَى رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَسَلَّمْ وَشَرَّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أيها الناس.
Indeed, the truest of speech is the book of Allah, and the best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa ala alihi wa sallam. And the worst of affairs in the religion are the newly invented matters, and every newly invented matter is an innovation, and every innovation is a misguidance, and every misguidance is in the hellfire. O mankind.
في قول الله عز وجل ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون.
There is found in the statement of Allah عز وجل, in what the translation means, and die not except in a state of Islam as Muslims.
حث على الاستمرار والمداومة على الطاعة.
An inciting and a prompting for one to be continuous and perseverant upon good deeds and righteous deeds.
وليس في ذلك أن الإنسان يضمن لنفسه الموت على الإسلام.
And mankind cannot promise to themselves that they will die in a state of Islam.
ولكن الله عز وجل يقول في كتابه الكريم فأما من أعطى واتقى وصدق بالحسنى
But verily, Allah has said, and as for him who gives in charity and keeps his duty to Allah and fears Him and believes in Al-Husna, the reward Al-Jannah, then we will make easy for him the path of ease. So the one who is continuous upon obedience and good deeds
وباتقاء الله سبحانه وتعالى.
By giving and keeping his duty to Allah.
وبالتصديق بما أعد الله للمؤمنين. والسعي في ذلك.
And believes in that which Allah has prepared for the believers and striving towards that.
فإن الله وصالح عباده يشكرون ذلك السعي.
Then verily Allah and His righteous servants will appreciate those efforts.
ومن أراد الآخرة وسعى لها سعيها وهو مؤمن فأولئك كان سعيهم مشكورا.
So the Shaykh, he quotes the ayat from the Quran where Allah says, and whosoever desires the hereafter and strives for it with the necessary effort due for it while he is a believer, then such are the ones whom striving shall be appreciated.
ما يفعل الله بعذابكم إن شكرتم وآمنتم وكان الله شاكرا عليما.
And Allah says, why should Allah punish you if you have thanked Him and believed in Him, and Allah is ever all appreciative, all knowing.
إن أمر المداومة على الطاعة لهو دليل بإذن الله عز وجل على أن العبد سيوفق وسيختم له بها.
Verily the affair of being continuous upon good deeds is an indication by the permission of Allah that the slave has been given tawfiq or success by Allah and will be taken by Allah in that state.
فقد قال عبد الله بن بشر يا رسول الله إن شرائع الإسلام قد كثرت علي فأخبرني بعمل أتشبث به أدخل به الجنة.
For verily, Abdullah ibn Busr, he said, O Messenger of Allah, verily the legislative acts of Islam have become too much for me, and due to my weakness not being able to carry them out, inform me of a deed that if I hold fast to and am continuous in, I may enter into paradise.
قال له رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يزال لسانك رطبا من ذكر الله.
So he صلى الله عليه وسلم replied to him and said that your tongue does not cease to be moist with the remembrance of Allah.
وهذا حث له على المداومة والاستمرار ومن كان كذلك يدخل الجنة بإذن الله. وربنا سبحانه وتعالى يقول في كتابه الكريم.
This was something that incited him to be consistent and perseverant, and whomsoever is like this, meaning perseverant upon righteous deeds, then they will enter into paradise بإذن الله. Our Lord says in His noble book,
وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ يَضِيقُ صَدْرُكَ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَكُنْ مِنَ السَّاجِدِينَ وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ.
And indeed, we know that your chest or your breast is tightened by what they say. So glorify the praises of your Lord and be of those who prostrate themselves to Him and worship your Lord until death comes to you.
وَاللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ فَعَلِمَ أَنَّ صَدْرَ نَبِيِّهِ كَانَ ضَيِّقًا مِنْ قَوْلِهِ وَأَرْشَدَهُ إِلَىٰ أُمُورٍ عَظِيمَةٍ في هذه الآية.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all-knowing of that which is in the breast of mankind. And He knew that the chest of His Prophet was constricted and tight from their statements. So He directed him to some great affairs in this ayat.
وَمِنْ ذَلِكَ التَّشْبِيحِ وَكَثْرَةُ السُّجُودِ لِلَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَكُنْ مِنَ السَّاجِدِينَ وَعِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ وَالْإِسْتِمْرَارِ عَلَى ذَلِكَ.
And from the affairs that he guided him to in this ayat was glorifying the praises of Allah and increasing in prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in worshipping Allah and being consistent in that.
فَإِنَّ هَذَا فَرَجٌ عَظِيمٌ وَنَصْرٌ عَزِيزٌ كَرِيمٌ الْإِسْتِمْرَارُ عَلَى طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ.
For verily this brings about a great relief from hardships and a great noble victory in being consistent upon obedience to Allah.
والله سبحانه وتعالى يقول في كتابه الكريم وهو الذي يقبل التوبة عن عباده ويعفو عن السيئات ويعلم ما تفعلون
ويستجيب الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات ويزيدهم من فضله والكافرون لهم عذاب شديد.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in His noble book, and it is He who accepts repentance from His slaves and forgives their sins. And He knows what you do, and He answers those who believe and do righteous deeds, and He gives them increase of His bounty. And for the disbelievers is a severe punishment.
فالمداوم على الإيمان والعمل الصالح لا يزال مزدادا من فضل الله في أمور دنياه وأخرى ما دام مداوما على طاعة الله عز وجل.
So the one who is persistent upon Iman and upon doing righteous deeds, then he will not cease to be increased by Allah's bounty in the affairs of this world and other than it, as long as he is persistent upon righteous deeds and upon obedience to Allah.
فَإِنَّ هَذَا الْعَمَلْ أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَإِنْ قَلْ.
For verily, this is from the most beloved deeds to Allah, even if they are small in number.
المداومة والاستمرار بذلك طيب الحياة. طيب الحياة بالمداومة على الطاعات.
For in being consistent and perseverant, then this is how one achieves a good life, attaining the goodness of life by remaining consistent upon righteous deeds.
ربنا سبحانه وتعالى يقول من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة ولنجزينهم أجرهم بأحسن ما كانوا يعملون.
As our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, whoever works righteousness, whether a male or female, while they are a true believer, then verily to him we will give a good life. And we shall pay them certainly a reward in proportion to the best of that which they used to do. And this is not specific to the hereafter, but also in this worldly life. He will be given a good life in this world and in the hereafter.
والجزاء الحسن في الدنيا والآخرة.
And a good reward in this world and in the hereafter.
وعقب الرزق الحسن كذلك في الدنيا والآخرة.
And also a good provision resulting from this in this world and in the hereafter.
هذا من أحب الأعمال إلى الله ولو كان قليلا.
And these are from the most beloved deeds to Allah, even if they are few and little in number.
ففي الصحيحين من حديث أم المؤمنين عائشة رضي الله عنها.
For it is recorded in the Sahihain in Bukhari and Muslim on the authority of Aisha radiallahu anha, mother of the believers, that she said,
أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ دَخَلَ عَلَيْهَا وَعِنْدَهَا امْرَأَةٌ فَجَعَلَتْ عَائِشَةَ تَذْكُرُ مِنْ صَلَاتِهَا فَقَالَ مَهْ عَلَيْكُمْ بِمَا تُطِيقُونَ فَوَاللَّهِ لَا يَمَلُّ اللَّهُ حَتَّى تَمَلُّوا وَكَانَ أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ مَا دَاوَمَ عَلَيْهِ صَاحِبُهُ.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam entered into the presence of Aisha radiallahu anha, and there was a woman sitting with her. So she started to praise him to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and mentioned to him about her excessive praying. So he said disapprovingly, "Do good deeds which are within your capacity, for by Allah, Allah will not get tired of giving rewards, but surely you will get tired, and the most beloved deeds to Allah is that which He is consistent in."
وروى البخاري في صحيحه من حديث أبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله عنه وللحديث شواهد في خارج الصحيح أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إذا مرض العبد أو سافر كتب له ما كان يعمل صحيحا مقيما.
And in Bukhari, in the hadith of Abi Musa al-Ash'ari رضي الله عنه, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said that if the servant gets sick or goes on a journey, then it will be written for him that which he used to do when he was well and healthy and a resident, not on a journey.
فالمداوم على العمل الصالح يستمر عليه عمله في الدنيا حتى وهو ميت.
So the one who is constant upon righteous deeds, his deeds will be ongoing in this world even if he is dead.
وعمله لا يزال يجري عليه بسبب ثباته على ذلك العمل وعدم تأرجحه وترنحه.
And his deeds will not cease to continue because of his steadfastness upon that deed and not being shaky with inconsistency and swaying back and forth. For verily, swaying back and forth is the characteristic of the hypocrites. He quotes the ayat where Allah says, and from mankind is he who worships Allah as if he were upon the edge. If good befalls him, he is content therewith. But if a trial befalls him, he turns back on his face, he loses both this world and the hereafter, and that is the evident loss.
أما المؤمن فإنه لا يزال يجري عليه عمله.
As for the believer, then verily his deeds will continue to be ongoing for him.
كل عمل ابن آدم إذا مات الإنسان انقطع عمله إلا من ثلاث: صدقة جارية أو علم ينتفع به أو ولد صالح يدعو له.
And then the Shaykh quotes the hadith: all the deeds of Bani Adam, if someone dies, all of his deeds will come to an end, except for three types of people: an ongoing charity, or knowledge which can be benefited by, or from a righteous child who supplicates for his father. Deeds that the person used to be consistent in will continue to be ongoing. And all deeds will cease and come to an end, except for the one who is a murabit in the way of Allah, the one who stationed himself between the Muslims and the enemy, guarding the Muslims.
Murabit mustamir, arribat min al-dawam wal-istimrar.
For the murabit, the one who is guarding in the way of Allah, then this is the things that cause your deeds to last and continue.
فَإِنَّهُ يُنَّى لَهُ عَمَلُهُ الَّذِي كَانَ يَعْمَلُ.
For verily his deeds will continue to grow for him from this deed which he used to be continuous in. And he will be safe from the punishment in the grave. His deeds will continue to be ongoing, and he will be safe from the punishment in the grave because he was somebody who was guarding in the way of Allah against the enemy. And the case is similar to the one who is striving and being consistent upon obedience to Allah. And the bounty of Allah is vast and it is far-reaching.
أيها الناس إن أمر المداومة على الطاعات شأن المؤمنين ومن أسباب زيادة الإيمان.
And the Shaykh says, O mankind, verily the affair of being consistent upon good deeds is a trait of the believers and from the reasons for increasing إيمان.
احذر أن تقصر في الطاعة يضعف إيمانك وتنهزم أمام أعدائك والشيطان.
So be cautious that you should fall short in good deeds, lest your iman decrease, and you get defeated in front of your enemies and the shaytan. And all of this is due to your sins. So if you are able to do good deeds, and then you left it. Able to be a student of knowledge and seeking ilm, and then you left it.
قادرا على قيام الليل ثم تتركه.
Able to pray the night prayer and then you left it.
كل ذلك يدل على ضعف في الإيمان.
All of this indicates a weakness in إيمان.
وبقدر ضعف الإيمان يضعف الإنسان.
And due to the extent of your weakness in إيمان, you yourself will become weak.
ويزيد الله الذين اهتدوا هدى.
And the Shaykh quoted the ayat where Allah says, and Allah increases in guidance those who are rightly guided. So the more a person becomes rightly guided, Allah increases him in guidance. And the more a person increases in iman, Allah will increase him. And the honor of a person is due to the strength of his iman. And the weakness of a person, and the slackness that he feels, and the humiliation of a person is due to his weakness in iman, and the honor of a person is due to the strength of his iman. So the more a person increases in iman, so will his closeness to Allah increase, as well as the goodness and the kindness that he does.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قد قرن السعادة بالإيمان والعمل الصالح، فاحذر أن يضعف إيمانك بضعف طاعتك وأعمالك وكل ذلك.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has connected happiness to iman and doing righteous deeds. So be cautious that your iman decreases due to weakness in you being obedient to Allah and doing righteous deeds.
كلما ازداد عملك الصالح قوي ايمانك وسعدت في هذه الحياة الدنيا.
So for every time your righteous deeds increase, so will your iman. And as a result of this, you will acquire happiness in this worldly life.
ثبت في صحيح مسلم من حديث حنظلة بن الربيع رضي الله عنه أنه قال يا رسول الله إنا إذا كنا عندك تذكرنا الجنة والنار كأننا رأي العين، أي كأننا نراها رأي العين، يشتد خوفهم ويزداد إيمانهم.
It has been established in Sahih Muslim on the authority of Hanzala ibn al-Rabi' that he said, O Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, when we were in your company, you remind us of the hellfire and the Jannah, and we feel as if we can see it with our own eyes, meaning that their fear increases and their iman increases. But when we go away from you, and we attend to our wives and our children and our businesses, much of these things go out of our minds.
قال عليه الصلاة والسلام يا حنظلة والذي نفسي بيده لو تدومون على ما أنتم عليه عندي وفي الذكر لفاصحتكم الملائكة على فرشكم وفي الطرقات ولكن يا حنظلة ساعة وساعة.
Thereupon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said, O Hanzala, by him in whose hand is my soul, if your state of mind remained the same as it did in my presence and you were always busy in remembrance, the angels would shake your hands with you while you were in your beds and on your roads. But Hanzala, there is a time for this and a time for that.
فأدان له رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فضل ذلك الذي كانوا عليه عنده وأنهم لو كانوا على ذلك الخير لصافحتهم الملائكة.
So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made clear to them the virtue of what they felt when they were in his company. And if they were to remain in that state, then verily the angels would shake their hands.
وَأَذَانَ لَهُ أَنَّ مَا يَفْعَلُونَ مِنْ مُعَافَةِ الزَّوْجَاتِ وَالْأَوْلَادِ وَالضَّيْعَاتِ أَمْرٌ مُبَاحٌ لَيْسَ بِمُنْكَرٍ وَلَا مُحَرَّمٍ مَا لَمْ يَشْغَلْ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَلَكِنْ هَذَا الْأَمَلْ لَا تُسَافِحِ الْمَلَائِكَ صَاحِبَهُ.
And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also made clear to them that that which they were doing by attending to their wives and their children and their businesses was something that was allowed and permissible. It is not something that is criticized nor prohibited as long as it does not busy oneself from the remembrance of Allah. But it wasn't due to that action that the angels would come down and shake their hands. And this shows the virtue of being persistent upon obedience to Allah.
أخرج البخاري في صحيحه من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه في النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما يروي عن ربه عز وجل.
It has been recorded in Bukhari on the authority of Abi Hurairah رضي الله عنه that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that his Lord has said
أنه قال من عادى لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب.
Whoever treats with hostility or enmity a pious worshipper of mine, then I have declared war against them. And my slave does not cease to come closer to me through performing voluntary acts until I love him. So the Shaykh, he said, pay attention with me and observe the word in the hadith that says, my slave does not cease, for verily it indicates consistency and perseverance.
إذا أردت أن يحبك الله زد في الطاعة واستمر عليها واحذر الانقطاع عن طاعة الله عز وجل.
So if you want Allah to love you, then increase in righteous deeds and be consistent in them, and be aware of discontinuance, of inconsistency in righteous deeds.
ولا يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه.
And he returns back to the hadith by saying that Allah says, my slave does not cease to come closer to me through performing voluntary acts until I love him. And this is the utmost goal of the believer. Exert an effort and striving to attain the love of the Lord of the worlds. And let's see what results from this. And when I love him, I become his hearing with which he hears. And his sight with which he sees. And his hand with which he strikes. And if he asks of me something, I will surely give it to him. And if he seeks my protection, my refuge, I will surely give him refuge and protection.
دعاءك مستجاب وسؤالك مرضى بكر.
So the Shaykh, he explains it by saying, your supplication will be answered and you will be given what you ask for and it will be honored.
والله سبحانه وتعالى ما يوفق سمعك وبصرك وجوارحك كل ذلك بتقربك بالأعمال الصالحة والاستمرار على ذلك.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you by way of Him protecting your hearing, your eyes and your limbs from disobedience to Him. All of this due to you gaining closeness to Allah through righteous deeds and being consistent in them.
وفي الصحيحين أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من تقرب أنا عند حسن ظن عبدي بي وأنا معه إذا سألني.
And it has been reported in Bukhari and Muslim that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah azza wa jal, he said, I am the good thought that my slave thinks I am, and I am with him when he supplicates to me.
فَإِذَا ذَكَرَنِي فِي نَفْسِهِ ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي نَفْسِهِ وَإِذَا ذَكَرَنِي فِي مَلَئٍ ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي مَلَئٍ خَيْرٍ مِنْهُمْ.
And if he mentions me to himself, I mention him to myself. And if he mentions me in a gathering, I mention him in a gathering that is greater and better than that one.
وَإِذَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ شِبْرًا تَقَرَّبْتُ إِلَيْهِ ذِرَاعًا وَإِذَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ ذِرَاعًا تَقَرَّبْتُ إِلَيْهِ ذِرَاعًا.
And when he comes closer to me by a hand span, I come closer to him in arm's length. And if he draws closer to me by an arm's length, I draw closer to him by a distance of two outstretched arms nearer to him.
وَإِذَا أَتَانِي يَمْشِي أَتَيْتُهُ هَرْوَلًا.
And if my servant comes to me walking, I go to him running. And this is the hadith whereby the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is narrating what his Lord had said to him. And the point taken from this, is that if you become slack and become weak in drawing close to your Lord, then verily your closeness to Allah Azza wa Jal will also start to become weak. And depending on your strength and vigor within your actions, you will be provided for and also helped from Allah Azza wa Jal. And the Shaykh, he quoted the ayat where Allah Azza wa Jal, he says in the translation, and the bounties of your Lord can never be forbidden.
إلى شأن الصالحين من الأنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام والصحابة والتابعين كيف كان جدهم في الاستمرار والمداومة على الأعمال الصالحة.
Take a look at the nature of the righteous from the prophets عليهم السلام and the companions and those that followed them at their striving and eagerness in being consistent and persistent upon righteous deeds.
الاستمرار بركة من الله عز وجل.
And consistency is a blessing from Allah Azza wa Jal.
فنبيالله عيسى عليه الصلاة والسلام يقول الله له.
And the Prophet Isa عليه السلام, whom Allah will address by saying,
إذ قال الله يا عيسى أأنت قلت للناس اتخذوني وأمي إلهين من دون الله قال سبحانه ما يكون لي أن أقول ما ليس لي بحق إن كنت قلته فقد علمته تعلم ما في نفسي ولا أعلم ما في نفسك إنك أنت علام الغيوب.
And when Allah will say, O Isa, son of Maryam, Did you say to men, worship me and my mother as two gods besides Allah? He will say, Subhanak, glorified to you. It was not for me to say that which I had no right to say. Had I had such a thing, you would surely have known it. You know what is in my inner self, though I do not know what is in yours. Truly you, only you, are the all-knower of which is hidden and unseen.
ما قلت لهم إلا ما أمرتني به أن اعبدوا الله إلا ما أمرتني به ما قلت لهم إلا ما أمرتني به أن اعبدوا الله ربي وربكم فلما توفيتني كنت أنت الرقيب عليهم وأنت على كل شيء شهيد.
Never did I say to them except that which you did command me to say, worship Allah, my Lord and your Lord, and I was a witness over them as long as I dwelt amongst them. But then when you took me up, you were the watcher over them, and you are a witness to all things.
شهد لما دمت فيهم ما يزال مستمرا دائبا ساعيا في دعوته إلى الله إلى عبادة الله وتوحيده ما دام فيه.
Our point taken from the ayat is Isa's statement, as long as I dwelt amongst them. So this shows that he remained consistent, devoted, untiring, striving in calling to the worship of Allah and His oneness as long as he dwelt amongst them.
وهو القائل إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب وجعلني نبيا.
And he, Allah Azza wa Jal, is also the one who said, referring to Isa in the Quran, he, Isa, said, verily I am a slave of Allah and He has given me the scripture and made me a prophet.
وجعلني مباركا أينما كنت وأوصاني بالصلاة والزكاة ما دمت حيا.
And He made me blessed wheresoever I may be, and has enjoined upon me the prayer and zakat as long as I live.
هذه وصية الله لرسول الله الاستمرار والمداومة على الأعمال الصالحة.
And this was the instruction of Allah given to the Messenger of Allah to remain consistent and continuous upon righteous deeds.
وإنه لقاسم للطهر أن يعمل الإنسان العمل برهة من الظن ثم يترنح إلى الخبر.
And verily he, Allah Azza wa Jal, is the one who swears by time that mankind will carry out deeds for a short while and then he will sway and get shaky and go backwards.
ونعوذ بالله من الحور بعد الكور ودعوة المظلوم.
And we seek refuge in Allah from falling backwards after proceeding forward, meaning falling into sin after being upon obedience to Allah, and from the supplication of the one who is oppressed.
ففي الصحيحين من حديث ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال.
And it is found in Bukhari and Muslim from the hadith of Ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said.
حدثنا الصادق المصدوق إن أحدكم ليعمل بعمل أهل الجنة حتى ما يكون بينه وبينها إلا ذراع فيسبق عليه الكتاب فيعمل بعمل أهل النار.
And he's the truthful one, the one who is believed, said, verily, one of you performs the acts of the people of paradise until there is but an arm's length between him and it. And that which has been written overtakes him, so he starts to behave and perform the acts of the people of the hellfire, and thus he enters it. And the hadith is found in Bukhari and Muslim, and the point taken from it is this wording.
يقول إذا أراد الله بعبده خيرا عسله قالوا وما عسله وفي رواية غسله قال يقيض له عملا صالحا يقبضه عليه يستمر عليه حتى يموت عليه.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said, if Allah wants good for his slave, he عسله. And in another narration he said غسله. So they said, Ya Rasulullah, what is عسله? So he replied, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah bounds him to a righteous deed and then makes him consistent upon it up until the point of his death. This is in order that you may know the virtue of being consistent in righteous deeds.
وفي الصحيحين من حديث حكيم بن حزام رضي الله عنه قال سألت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فأعطاني ثم سألته فأعطاني ثم سألته فأعطاني ثم قال يا حكيم إن هذا المال خضر سلول فمن أخذه بطيب نفس بورك له فيه.
And in Bukhari and Muslim from the hadith of Hakim ibn Hizam رضي الله عنه that he said, I asked the Messenger of Allah for something and he gave me. I asked him again and he gave me. I asked him again and he gave me. Then he said, O Hakim, verily this wealth is green and sweet and whoever takes it without greed, then it will be blessed for him.
ومن أخذه بإشراف نفس لم يبارك له فيه وكان كالذي يأكل ولا يشبع.
And whoever takes it with greed, then it will not be blessed for him, and he will be like the one who eats and does not get satisfied.
واليد العليا خير من اليد السفلى. قال قلت والله يا رسول الله لا أرزع بعدك أحدا.
And the upper hand is better than the lower hand. So I said, by Allah, O Messenger of Allah, I will never demand anything from anybody after you.
فكان أبو بكر بعد موت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يعطي حكيما نصيبه فيأبى.
So after the death of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr used to call Hakim to give him something from his share, but he would refuse.
ويرسل له عمر بن الخطاب نصيبه من الفيء فيأبى يقول أشهدكم يا معشر المسلمين ألا حكيم بن حزام أعطيه حظه من الفيء فيأبى.
And then Umar ibn al-Khattab would send to him his share from that which Allah had ordained for him from the booty, and he refused to take it. So he said, O assembly of Muslimin, I call you to bear witness that I give Hakim ibn Hizam his share from the booty, and he refuses to accept it.
قَالَ فَمَا رَزَعَ حَكِيمٌ أَحَدًا حَتَّى مَاتْ وَفَاءً لِمَا وَعَدَ بِهِ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمْ وَاسْتِمْرَارًا وَدَوَامًا عَلَى مَا قَالَهُ وَثَبَاتًا عَلَى ذَلِكَ.
And it was said that Hakim never asked anything of anybody until he died, carrying out and fulfilling that which he promised to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and being continuous and consistent upon that which he said and being steadfast upon it.
أخرج الإمام مسلم في صحيحه من حديث ثعبان بن بهجلة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال.
And it has been recorded in Sahih Muslim on the authority of Thawban that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said,
من يضمن لي من يتكفل لي ألا يسأل الناس شيئا وأتكفل له الجنة. قال ثوبان أنا.
Who guarantees me that they will not ask anything from anyone and I will guarantee him Jannah? So Thawban said, I give you the guarantee.
فما سأل ثوبان أحدا حتى مات ولا يزال مداوما على ذلك الأمل حتى لقي الله.
So Thawban, he never asked anything from anyone until he died. So he remained consistent upon that deed until he met Allah. And this is how the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to be. And there comes in a hadith where 9 or 8 or 7 people came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said to them, will you not give the pledge? So they said, O Messenger of Allah, verily we gave you the pledge. So they said, O Messenger of Allah, on what shall we give you the pledge?
قال على أن تعبد الله شريك به شيئا ولا تسأل الناس شيئا أسر كلمة.
So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to them that you worship Allah alone and join none along in worship with him, and that you do not ask anything of the people. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he whispered something to them.
قال فلقد رأيت أولئك النفر يسقط صوت أحدهم فلا يقول ناولي.
So he, the narrator of the hadith, went on to say that verily I saw those who made the pledge to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that even when one of the sword of one of them or the whip of one of them dropped, that they wouldn't ask of anyone to pass it to them.
وفاءً واستمرارًا ومداومةً على العمل الصالح.
And they did this in order to fulfill that which they pledged to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and to remain continuous and consistent and perseverant upon righteous deeds.
وفي الصحيحين من حديث كعب بن مالك رضي الله عنه أنه لما تاب الله عليه قال يا رسول الله إن الله إنما أنجاني بالصدق.
And it is recorded in Bukhari and Muslim on the authority of Ka'b ibn Malik that when Allah accepted his repentance, he said, O Messenger of Allah, verily Allah only saved me for telling the truth.
وإن من توبتي أن لا أحدث إلا صدقا حتى ألقى الله.
And so part of my repentance is to adhere to telling the truth until I meet Allah.
قال كعب فوالله ما أبلى الله أحدا فيما أعلم بمثل ما أبلاني في صدق الحديث والله ما تأمت كذبة منذ ذكرت ذلك لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى يوم هذا وأرجو أن يحفظني الله بما بقي.
So Ka'b said, by Allah, I do not know anyone among the Muslims whom Allah had put to test in being truthful in speech better than that which He had put me to trial with. And I've never intended to tell a lie. Since that time I mentioned that to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam up until this day today. And verily I hope that Allah will protect me from telling a lie and preserve me in being truthful in speech for that which remains of my life.
استمراراً ومدامةً على ذلك.
And this was in order to be consistent and continuous upon that deed.
أخرج الشيخان في صحيحيهما من حديث ابن عمر رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال نعم الرجل عبد الله لو كان يقوم الليل فما ترك عبد الله قيام الليل صلاة الليل وكان لا ينام من الليل قليلا.
And it is reported in Bukhari and Muslim from the hadith of Ibn Umar that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he said, "What a great person Abdullah would be if he only stood for the prayer during the night." So Abdullah he never left standing for the prayer during the night, and he only used to sleep during the night except a little.
استمراراً على العمل مداومة على ذلك.
This was in order to be consistent and perseverant upon that.
أخرج الإمام مسلم في صحيحه من حديث عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنه. أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من فاته حزبه من الليل فقضاه من النهار بين صلاة الفجر وصلاة الظهر كأنما صلاه من الليل.
And it is recorded in Sahih Muslim from the hadith of Abdullah bin Umar that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said, whosoever portion of the night prayer escapes him or passes him by, then let him carry it out in the day between Salat al-Fajr and Salat al-Dhuhr, and he will be rewarded as if he prayed it during the night.
حفاظاً على الأمل ومدامة عليه فإن الله يأجر على ذلك.
This is in order to guard his deeds and be consistent upon them, for verily Allah will reward him for that.
أخرج الإمام مسلم في صحيحه من حديث عائشة رضي الله عنها أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان إذا فاته قيام الليل لمرض أو غيره صلاه ما بين الظهر وما بين الفجر 12 ركعة مداومة على العمل حتى لا تنقص أعماله.
And it is recorded in Sahih Muslim from the hadith of Aisha رضي الله عنها that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that if he صلى الله عليه وسلم missed the night prayer due to the reason of him being sick or any other reason, then he would pray between صلاة الظهر and صلاة الفجر 12 ركعة, being consistent upon that deed in order that his deeds would not decrease in any way.
هكذا كانوا يداومون على الأعمال ويستمرون عليها لأن هذا شيء محبوب إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And this is how they used to remain steadfast and consistent upon doing righteous deeds, because this was something that was beloved to Allah.
والانقطاع سبب الفشل, سبب الفشل وسبب الهلاك.
And discontinuance in good deeds is a cause for failure and destruction.
فقد أخرج فقد ثبت من حديث عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لكل عمل شرة ولكل شرة فترة فمن كانت فترته إلى سنتي أي إلى العمل الصالح والسنة ما زال على طاعة الله فقد نجا في رواية فقد أفلح.
For verily it is established on the authority of Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam he said, for every deed there is a period of enthusiasm, and for every period of enthusiasm there is a period of slow activity. So whosoever period of enthusiasm was towards my sunnah, meaning good deeds and to the sunnah, remaining in obedience to Allah, then verily he has been saved. And in another narration it says, verily he has been successful.
وَمَنْ كَانَتْ فَتْرَتُهُ غَيْرِ ذَلِكَ فَقَدْ هَلَكَ.
And whosoever's period of slow activity was towards other than that, then he is destroyed.
الانقطاع عن السنة وعن العمل الصالح هلاك ونعوذ بالله.
So discontinuance of being upon the sunnah and upon righteous deeds is destruction, and we seek refuge in Allah from that.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا أما بعد.
All praise is due to Allah, we praise Him. We seek His aid, we seek His forgiveness. I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped except for Allah alone, who has no partner. And I bear witness that Muhammad is His slave and His messenger. and may excessive prayers and peace be upon the Prophet and his family to proceed.
فإن الاستمرار على الخير دليل الخير والانقطاع عن الخير صرف عن الخير.
For verily a person being consistent upon good is an indication that Allah wants good for that slave. And discontinuance in doing khair and doing good is something that turns one away from doing khair.
وربنا عز وجل يقول في كتابه الكريم مبينا شأن ذلك الذي لم يستمر على الخير وانقطع عنه.
And our Lord has said in his noble book, clarifying the affair of the one who is not consistent upon good and discontinues in it.
واتل عليهم نبأ الذي آتيناه آياتنا فانسلخ منها أي لم يستمر ولم يستقم ولم يمضي على ذلك فأتبعه الشيطان.
And the translation of the ayat is, and recite unto them the story of whom we gave our ayat, but he threw them away, meaning that he was not consistent, not upright, not carrying that out. So Shaytan followed him up.
ولاحظ هذه الآية وانتبه أن من انقطع عن الخير كان في عقبه إبليس الذي ينقطع عن الخير ولم يستمر عليه يتبعه الشيطان.
Pay attention to this ayat and take heed that the one who discontinues upon khair, then Iblis is right behind him. The one who discontinues upon the khair, upon the good he was doing, and stops being continuous in righteous deeds, Shaytan follows him up. And he will try to steer him into one calamity after another, one adversity after another, distress after distress, fitna after fitna, up until he makes him reach to that which Allah has already predestined for him.
نعم فأتبعه الشيطان فكان من الغاوين ولو شئنا لرفعناه بها ولكنه أخلد إلى الأرض واتبع هواه فمثله كمثل الكلب إن تحمل عليه يلهث أو تتركه يلهث.
And the translation of the rest of the ayat reads, so Shaytan followed him up and he became of those who went astray. And had we willed, we would surely have elevated him therewith. But he clung to the earth and followed his own vain desire. So the likeness and the parable is the parable of a dog. If you drive him away, he lolls his tongue out. And if you leave him alone, he still lolls his tongue out.
إِنَّ بِالْإِسْتِمْرَارِ عَلَى الْعَمَلِ الصَّالِحِ تُرْزَقِ الرِّزْقِ الْحَسَنِ أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنِ.
O believer, verily with consistency upon righteous deeds, you will receive good provision.
يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة ومن الحياة الطيبة رزق للرزق الحسن.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in his noble book, in the translation, whoever works righteousness, whether male or female, while they are a true believer, verily to him we will give a good life. And the Shaykh said a good life consists of a good provision.
ويقول سبحانه في كتابه الكريم وذنون إذ ذهب مغاضبا فظن أن لن نقدر عليه فنادى في الظلمات أن لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين فاستجبنا له ونجيناه من الغم وكذلك ننجي المؤمنين.
And Allah subhanahu says in his noble book, and remember then Noon, which is Yunus, when he went off in anger and imagined that we shall not punish him. But he cried through the darkness saying, La ilaha illa ant. None has the right to be worshipped but you. Glorified and exalted are you above all the evil that they associate with you. Truly, I have been of the wrongdoers, the zalimeen. So Allah says, so we answered his call and delivered him from the distress. And thus do we deliver and save the believers.
لما كان له من السابقية العظيمة ومن العمل المستمر الدائم فرج الله عنه بسبب عمله وإيمانه.
So the Shaykh, he said, when he possessed this trait in trying to be foremost and striving and remaining consistent upon these righteous deeds that he was devoted in, then Allah made a way out for him due to his deeds that were righteous and due to his Iman.
فالعمل الصالح والاستمرار عليه ساء سبب للفرج من الشدائد والنكبات.
So righteous deeds and being continuous upon them is a reason and a means for relief in times of difficulty and hardships and calamities.
إن العمل الصالح ليحفظك الله به ويحفظ ذريتك من بعدك إذا أنت عملت صالحا. احفظ الله يحفظك.
Verily by doing righteous deeds, Allah will protect you due to it and your generation that comes after you if you work righteousness. Taken from the hadith, be mindful of Allah and He will be mindful of you and protect you.
يحفظك من الفتن ويحفظك في دينك ودنياك وفي أهلك ومالك.
Protect you from trials, from fitan, and protect you in your religion and your worldly affairs, your wealth and your family.
وأما الجدار فكان لغلامين يتيمين في المدينة وكان تحته كنز لهما وكان أبوهما صالحا فأراد ربك أن يبلغا أشدهما ويستخرجا كنزهما رحمة من ربك وما فعلته عن أمري.
And the Shaykh quoted the ayah in the Quran referring to the story of Musa and Khadr, where Khadr, he said, "And as for the wall, it belonged to two orphan boys in the town, and there was under it a treasure belonging to them. And their father was a righteous man. And your Lord intended that they should attain their age of full strength and take out their treasure as a mercy from your Lord. And I did that action not of my own accord."
أوحى الله إلى نبيه خضر أن يقيم ذلك الجدار فأقامه حفاظا على مال أولئك الأيتام الصالح أبوهما.
So Allah revealed to His Prophet Khadr to erect that wall. So He erected it in order to preserve and protect the wealth of those orphans whose father was righteous.
نعم عباد الله حافظوا على الأعمال الصالحة. إن الذي ينقطع عن العمل الصالح يتبعه الشيطان.
Yes, worshippers of Allah, guard and protect your righteous deeds, for verily the one who discontinues in it, Shaytan follows him up.
ولهذا تلاحظ أن الشيطان يركز بدقة على من كان في عمل صالح ثم انقطع أشد مما يركز على من كان متماديا في الباطل من أول وهلة.
And because of this you will notice that Shaytan, he focuses on a person who was doing righteous deeds and then discontinues in them more than the one who is already adhering to falsehood from the very first moment.
لأن الله يقول فأتبعه الشيطان فكان من الغاوين.
And this is due to the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal saying in the translation, so Shaytan followed him up and he became of those who were astray.
وتلاحظ أن من تردى بعد الاستقامة أنه يصير مبغوضا عند الناس أشد من شرابة الخمر في الشوارع.
And you will notice and observe that the one who gets worse after being upright, he becomes more disliked and detested amongst the people than the one who drinks alcohol in the streets.
لأن هؤلاء عصاة فجرة معروفون الناس يقولون نسأل الله يهديهم ويصلحهم. لكن هذا الذي يتردى بعد أن عرف الحق ورآه وسمعه ودعا وإليه دعا عرف الحق ووعى وسمعه وإليه دعا ترى أن الناس ينقتونه أكثر.
For the reason that these people who are drinking in the streets, they're sinners, they're shameless sinners, they're known amongst the people. The people say about them, may Allah guide them, we ask Allah to rectify them. But as for the one who deteriorates and gets worse after he knew the truth, after he heard it and he called to it and gave da'wah to it, you'll see that the people detest him even more so.
ما باله ما باله بل حتى العصاة الفجرة يقول ما بالك بفلان فما فلان يصير شامتا بمن كان إماما له أو خطيبا له أو داعيا له ثم انحرف وصار إلى شاكلته ولو كان أرد ذلك العاصي منه في المعاصي.
Rather, even to the point that those shameless sinners start to say, what's wrong with such and such? They start to speak ill of the one who used to be their imam, the one who used to give them khutbas, the one who used to call them to the good, to the khair, because he deviated and became just like them. Even if those who are speaking ill of him are worse off than him.
ويصير شامتا به إنها فضيحة من الله سبحانه وتعالى فأتبعه الشيطان فكان من الغاوين.
And he speaks ill of him. And verily this is an exposure from Allah where he's being disgraced. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, and Shaytan followed him up and he became of those whom are astray.
الغواية تتراكم وتتوالى وتزداد على هذا.
And verily this astrayness accumulates and piles up and follows in succession and will increase upon this person.
العمل الصالح نجاة لك بإذن الله سبحانه وتعالى من الفتن بل وتمكين لك.
And righteous deeds, is something that will save you from this by Allah's permission, and from the fitnah and the trials. Rather, righteous deeds is a strengthening and a fortification for you.
لا تحاول لا تحاول أن تمكن في الأرض وأنت عاصي لا تحاول حتى وإن ملكت الدنيا فإن هذا ليس بتمكين هذا ردة وفتنة.
So do not attempt or even try to attempt to establish yourself in the earth while you are a sinner. Do not attempt it. Even if you owned or possessed the whole dunya, the whole world, verily this is not establishment. Rather, this is ruin and destruction and fitna.
وإنما التمكين أن ينشر الله خيرك وأن يستشرح الله صدرك فإن الله قد امتن على نبيه بشرح الصدر ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك.
For verily establishment is only when Allah will spread your khair and spread your good and open your chest to the truth. For verily Allah Azza wa Jal bestowed His blessing and His favors upon His Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam by opening his chest. As Allah has stated in the Quran, which the translation reads, "Have we not opened your breast for you and removed from you your burden?"
فَمَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَهْدِيَهُ يَشْرَحْ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ وَمَنْ يُرِدْ أَنْ يُضِلَّهُ يَجْعَلْ صَدْرَهُ ضَيِّقًا حَرَجًا.
As Allah has also stated in the Quran, He says, "And whomsoever Allah wills to guide, He opens his breast to Islam. And whomsoever He wills to send astray, He makes his breast closed and constricted."
أَفَمَنْ شَرَحَ اللَّهُ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ فَهُوَ عَلَى نُورٍ مِّن رَبِّهِ.
And Allah Azza wa Jal, He also states, "Is he whose breast Allah has opened to Islam, so that he is upon a light from his Lord, like the one who is not?"
لَا تَحَاوِلْ وتظن أن هذا تمكين ولو ملكت الدنيا ما لم تكن على استقامة وعلى أمل دائم صالح دائم.
So I say again, do not attempt to establish yourself in the earth, and do not think that this is establishment in the earth, even if you possess the whole entire earth. As long as you are not upon uprightness and you are not upon consistent righteous deeds, then do not even attempt to do this.
وعد الله الذين آمنوا منكم وعملوا الصالحات ليستخلفنهم في الأرض كما استخلف الذين من قبلهم.
Allah Azza wa Jal has stated in the Quran, which the translation reads, "Allah has promised those amongst you who believe and do righteous deeds that He will certainly grant them succession and establish them in the land, just as He granted it to those who came before them."
من الذي استخلفهم؟ هو الله سبحانه وتعالى. وبعضهم كان مولى واستخلفه الله وجعله قائدا للأمة ومرجعا للأمة وخلد الله ذكره في بطون الكتب بالعلم النافع والعمل الصالح ولا تقرأ ترجمته إلا وأنت تجله وتدعو له. هذا هو التمكين هذا هو التمكين بالعمل الصالح.
So who is the one that granted them succession and established them in the earth and established them in the land? It was Allah Azza wa Jal. Some of them used to be slaves, and Allah established them and made them leaders for the ummah and a point of reference for the people to refer back to. And He made their names to remain and continue to be mentioned deep inside the books of knowledge with regards to His beneficial knowledge and His righteous deeds. And you won't read His biography except that you honor Him and make dua for Him and supplicate for Him. This is establishment. This is establishment by way of righteous deeds.
وعد الله الذين آمنوا منكم وعملوا الصالحات ليستخلفنهم في الأرض كما استخلف الذين من قبلهم ولمكنن لهم دينهم الذي ارتضى لهم. أنت ارتضيت السنة ازدد في الطاعة حتى تمكن دعوتك إلى السنة.
Allah says in the ayat, Allah has promised those amongst you who believe and do righteous deeds that He will certainly grant them succession and establish them in the land, just as He granted to those who came before them, and that He will grant them the authority and strength and establish their religion which He is pleased with. So the Shaykh said, are you pleased and content with the sunnah? Then increase in righteous deeds so your da'wah can be established firmly to the sunnah.
أنت ارتضيت العلم ازدد في الطاعة حتى تمكن من العلم.
Are you pleased and content with knowledge? Then increase in righteous deeds so you are firmly established in knowledge.
أنت ارتضيت هذا النهج القويم؟ نعم. حتى تمكن من هذا النهج الذي أنت عليه ازدد في الطاعة.
Are you pleased and content with this straight way, this straight path that you are upon? Then increase in righteous deeds so you are firmly established upon this straight path that you are upon.
وإلا تفصم ويتبعك الشيطان والعياذ بالله ومن اتبعه الشيطان غوى.
And if you don't, then you will be detached and separated from it. And shaitan will follow right behind you, and Allah's refuge is sought. Because whomsoever shaitan follows, then they become astray.
هذا ونسأل الله التوفيق لما يحبه ورضاه الحمد لله.
And this amount is sufficient, and we ask Allah for the ability and the success to do that which He loves and is pleased with, and Alhamdulillah.